There's a revolution underway. A real estate revolution. Leading the charge is Kip Lohr, broker owner of Lohr Real Estate. Prepare to be educated, amused, and enlightened. Your calls and comments are welcome. 541-388-1110 or email talk@kbnd.com. Now, let the revolution begin.
Hello, Central Oregon. Welcome to the show, The Real Estate Revolution, brought to you by Kip Lohr, principal broker and owner of Lohr Real Estate here in Bend, Oregon. For those of you that are regular listeners, you may have noted that Kip, that's not the case. He's on assignment this weekend and asked if I would sit in. We have Sabrina here to handle the technical details, and I'll do my level best to get you fresh information that brings you to the real estate revolution. Hello, Central Oregon, and welcome to the show, The Real Estate Revolution, brought to you by Kip Lohr, principal broker and owner of Lohr Real Estate in Bend, Oregon. Those of you that are regular listeners to the show may have noted that Kip's voice has changed. That's not the case. He's on assignment this weekend and asked if I would sit in. My name is Fred Johnson with Duke Warner Realty. Duke Warner is the oldest independent brokerage in the area, family owned and operated since 1967, and I've been licensed in Central Oregon for over 30 years. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to be part of your day and being part of my first broadcast radio experience. Today we'll stay pretty close to Kip's normal format. We'll start with some activities, then we'll move to some feature properties. We'll go over some real-time activities and trends, and then settle on today's topic, our fall update for the Bend Real Estate Review of 2014, where we'll try to assess the activities and attempt to point out some opportunities in today's market. As your calls and comments are always welcomed at 541-388-1110. Please be gentle with me. And if I don't get to you today, you can always email me at fred@dukewarner.com. I'll get back to you promptly. So let's get going on this beautiful autumn day. Activities. This is the shoulder season. Someone once told me there's two seasons in Bend, one green and one brown. This weekend, there's not a lot of free music or festivals, but I would like to do a shout out for acreage owners, particularly those with irrigation. Hallelujah. The irrigation season for 2014 is finished this weekend. For those of you that aren't familiar, the season runs from April until October, and it's a love-hate relationship. After the brown season, March or April come around, and you'd like to green up the place and grow some things. But then after 6 or 7 months of moving irrigation line, mowing, and fussing with your pump and pond, the season end is a happy day. So take advantage of this beautiful day, weatherize your pump, and put away your irrigation lines. For you city folks, don't forget your sprinkler system, blow it out and weatherize it. It's a beautiful weekend to do that. Everyone should get off the couch and take advantage of this beautiful day. Take Fido for a walk, do some chores, but get out there and enjoy the foliage. It's a beautiful day. So Bend has been a dynamic market here in 2014. And so what we're going to do is we're going to open first with a little bit of the featured properties. And one of which is up at the end of 7th Mountain. The end of 7th Mountain, we have a condo, a one-bedroom, 672-square-foot condo for $159.9. It's fully furnished, two queen-size beds. It's on the third floor, so there's no ceiling noise. The end of 7th Mountain is the closest resort to Mount Bachelor, and that property is listed for $159.9. And it's a for sale by owner that is listed through Craigslist, and the contact number is 541-390-4697. A little closer to town, we have one at 2856 Northeast Solidia Lane for $219.9. It's 1,372 square feet, three-bedroom, two-and-a-half bath, built in 2005. It's just past Shopko. Nice, nice home, new carpet, new entry, counter. Comes complete with refrigerator, washer, and dryer near the hospital. And for this property, you'd contact Shelley Arnold at 541-771-9329. And then my third property today is actually in the Bridges off of 15th Street, a polish-built home on 61159 Southeast Ambassador Drive. It's a 2,190-square-foot, three-bedroom, two-and-a-half-bath home built in 2011. a great buy, great home. Shows like brand new. All the homes are completed on the street, granite counters. And for this property, you'd contact Julie Begoni at the Hassan Company, and her phone number is 541-306-8927. So that takes care of the properties. We have enough time to move on to activities. So our market data this year has been pretty interesting. As we started the year, we had a bit of a seller's market. And what a seller's market mean is that we had more buyers than properties. So what that meant is that the sellers had the ability to take advantage of that. But as the year has progressed, we're starting to see more inventory coming into the market, and the market is starting to stabilize a little bit, and we'll be able to get to that. As of today, there are 927 properties currently in Bend, which equates to 4.1 months of inventory. There were 45 new properties this week, as well as 74 properties that had price reductions. Currently, there's 210 properties that are new construction, which accounts for 22% of the active market. As we compare the solds year-to-date for 2013-2014, we'll see that there's been an average of 120 days as opposed to 115 days on the market. The average sales price rose a little bit from 311 to 345, and the median price increased from 267 to 288. That's about a 9% increase overall throughout the year. Now, I realize that the media tells us that we've been experiencing a 30% increase in our area, and that really only affects the lower reaches of the market. In other words, if you have a home that was $150,000 property and it's now listed at $195,000, that equates to a $30,000 increase in the value. At the higher end of the market, we're not seeing anywhere near that amount of activity. It didn't mean that someone with a $1 million home received a $300,000 increase in value in their property. So as we take a look at some of the market trends and what's happening, you know, with the comparative analysis process, we have a tendency to look at properties that are closed and they have closed in the last three months, the last 30 to 90 days. But generally, those properties have been transacted or entered into contract somewhere between 30 to 60 days prior to that. So that means that the properties that we're using for the comparative analysis could be as old as 5 months old when the transaction actually happened. So sometimes it's a little difficult for us to look forward while looking backward at the same time. But the one thing that's fairly notable in the statistics when you get into it a little bit is that we're seeing a little reduction in the number of properties that are actually selling and a little increase of properties and available properties that are entering the market. And so what that says to me is that there's probably a little bit of a transition from that seller's market that we experienced early in the season to a little bit more of an equilibrium, and possibly even moving on to a little bit of a buyer's market as fall comes on. So as I was reading yesterday, I was reading some things with Reuters that just basically confirms that we're experiencing a modest recovery. And we're coming back a little bit from the downfall of 2007-2009. 30-year mortgage rates have dropped to an all-time low. And many of the housing starts rose 1.1% in September, which is a good effort of a good activity. When we come back, we'll move forward and get into some of the definitions and what's happening with the market.